Cookerters, today we're going to go over how to multiply a mixed number by a fraction, how to multiply three mixed fractions, word problems, and how to divide a unit fraction by a whole number. So the first one, we're going to go over number 1 and number 3 together. Number 1 says 3 and 3 fifths, which is the whole number, which is the mixed fraction, times 1 third, which is the fraction. So when you're multiplying two different forms of fractions, you're going to convert your mixed fraction into an improper fraction, so it's much easier, because when you're multiplying fractions, you multiply the numerator by the denominator, but we also have to deal with the whole number now because of the mixed fraction, so we're going to change mixed number to an improper fraction where we only deal with the numerator and the denominator. So to convert a mixed fraction into an improper fraction, as a review, you're going to multiply the denominator and the whole number together, so you're going to do 5 times 3, and then you're going to add it by 3, the numerator. So you're going to do plus 3 like this. So when you do this, 5 times 3 is 15, plus 3, which is 18. And you keep the denominator the same, so you get 18 over 5 as your improper fraction. So now that we convert a mixed number into an improper fraction, we have 18 over 5 times 1 third. Now when you have this, you're just multiplying the numerator and the denominator. So 18 times 1 is 18, 5 times 3 is 15. But make sure to simplify, so we're going to simplify by dividing 3 from both numerator and denominator to get 6 over 5 as your final answer. So make sure to simplify. Now we're going to do number 3. So 3 and 2 third times 4 and 5. So 3 2 third is the mixed, 4 fifth is the fraction, and again we're going to change the mixed to an improper fraction so it's much easier to multiply. So to do this, we're going to multiply the denominator and the whole number, 3 times 3, and we're going to add it to the numerator, which is 2. So this is 3 times 3, 9, plus 2, which is 11. And that's your numerator, and your denominator you keep the same, so it's 11 over 3 as the improper fraction. So now we're going to do 11 over 3 times 4 fifths. And again, when you're multiplying numerator by denominator, you're just going to multiply the numerator and the denominator separately to get 44 over 15. And since this is already simplified, this is your final answer, 44 over 15. Now for the next section we're going to go over is multiply three mixed fractions. So now that we're dealing with three different, we're going to convert all three of them into an improper fraction and then multiply the numerator and the denominator together. So let's convert 4 and 1 sixth into a mixed fraction. So we're just going to go over number 1 together. So to do that, we're going to first do 6 times 4. Plus the numerator, which is 1 in this case. 6 times 4 is 24 plus 1, which is 25. So this is basically 25 over 6. Now we're going to do 1 and 1 8, 8 times 1 plus 1, which is basically 9. So it's 9 over 8. Now 3 and 1 7th, it's 21 plus 1, which is 22. So 22 over 7 as an improper fraction. Now we're dealing with 25 over 6 times 9 over 8 times 22 over 7. It's no different from multiplying with two mixed fractions, as it is with three mixed fractions. You're just multiplying the numerator and the denominator together. So now we're dealing with big numbers. We have to do 25 times 9 times 22. So I'll show you a shortcut way, which is basically simplifying. So we have 25 over here on the left. So to simplify 25, you have to look at the denominator, 6, 8, and 7. Can 25 be simplified with these three numbers? No. 9, can 9 be? Yes, it can with the 6. So we're going to take the 9 and simplify to 3 and 6 to 2. So basically what I did was divide 3 from both the numerator and the denominator. And 9 divided by 3 is 3, 6 divided by 3 is 2. Now we're going to move on to 22. 22 can be divisible with the 2 as they're both divisible by 2. 22 becomes 11, 2 becomes 1. And now we're going to use these new numbers, 25, 3, 11 as your new numerator, and 1, 8, 7 as your new denominators. Now this is the furthest you can ever simplify, so we're going to do 25 times 3. 75 times 11. So it's 825 over 56. And we know this is already simplified because we already simplified over here. So 825 over 56 is your final answer for number 1. This involves more steps, but it's basically the same thing. Now word problems, multiplication with mixed numbers. We're going to do number 1 together. It says write your answer as a fraction or as a whole or mixed number. So basically no improper fraction. So number 1, it says, last month, Emmy and Kelly sold candy to raise money for their debate team. Kelly sold 1/3 as many candy as Emmy did. Emmy sold 1 1/3 box of candy. How many boxes of candy did Kelly sell? Well, first of all, we know Kelly sold 1/3 as much as Emmy did. And we know Emmy sold 1 1/3. So basically, what we had to do is 1 1/3 times 1/3. Now, when you're multiplying mixed number by a fraction, we're going to change the mixed number into an improper fraction. To do that, we're going to do 3 times 1, the denominator times the whole number, and we're going to add it to the numerator. So that's 4 over 3. So we keep the denominator same. And we're going to do this times 1/3. We're going to do numerator and denominator separately, which is 4 over 9. So how many boxes of candy did Kelly sell? Kelly sold 4 1/9 of a box. Now the last section we're going to go over is dividing unit fractions by a whole number. Divide and simplify. So when you're dividing, you have to change the second number and put it over a reciprocal. So I'll show you what that means. So number 1, it says 1, 8 divided by 2. So it's best when you're dividing fractions, you're going to change the whole number into fraction. So we're going to do 1, 8 divided by 2 over 1, because 2 equals 2 over 1. Now with this, when you're dividing unit fractions, I said you're going to change the number, the second number. Reciprocal means going from 2 over 1 to 1 over 2. Another example is when you have 3/4 and you're taking a reciprocal of that, it will be 4/3. So basically just reversing, you're switching the places of the numerator and denominator. And we're going to do that with a second number, so it'll be half. And when you take the reciprocal, the division sign will change into multiple sign. And from here, as we would just multiply a regular fraction, we're going to do 1 times 1, the numerator by numerator, and denominator by denominator to get 1 over 16. So if you're not familiar with dividing fractions, this will be a new concept. So I will go over another problem, number 3. So we have 1/4 divided by 4. So always convert both of them into a fraction. So I just need to change 4 into a fraction, so it's 4 over 1. Now with that, I'm going to take the reciprocal of the second number, second term, and change it to 1/4. So 4 over 1 reciprocal is 1 over 4. So basically just cross, changing it. And the division sign changes to a multiple sign. And with this, multiply the numerator and denominator to get 1 over 16. So same answer as number 1. And that's it for today.